more information when we get it. Moving on, as the country's capital, Nairobi, witnessed pockets of violent clash between protesters and the police, the situation was different in other towns. There was relative calm in Nakuru and Mombasa, where traders went on with their business as usual. In Nakuru, however, James Mbugwa, who has been a vocal protester, was injured during a scuffle with the police after they accused him of attempting to mobilize protesters to the streets. Ken Gashuhi reports.
Peace and calmness ruled Nakuru City on Thursday, allowing businesses and transport to continue as normal amid fears of the anticipated nane protests. A heavy contingent of police was deployed to ensure peace and security in the town.
Demonstrations of today zilikuwa zikuwe Nairobi, not at county level. That is why Nakuru tuko cool.
Anafurahi kwa sababu baba wakati walizungumza na rais wakasema wacha watengeneza serikali ya national unity, which is good. Sisi hatungetaka maandamano kila wakati kwa sababu kila wakati furugu inapotokea walemavu ndio umia zaidi.
As President William Ruto presided over the swearing in of the new look cabinet, a section of Nakuru youth were not contented with his choices, saying that soon they may be back on the streets.
The president chose to ignore the young generation wenye wametumia 1 million kusoma lakini hawajawahi andikwa na taifa lao la Kenya. So nane itaendelea.
Wasee kinoparanya kina joo watu wa mabilionea mabwenyenye ndio napatia kazi. Itakuwaje? Utakumbuka mwana bodaboda aje?
The day was not without drama as police arrested one James Bogwa, a person living with disability who has been at the forefront agitating for change during previous protests. On July 16, he was tear-gassed but was unable to escape like other people. He wasn't lucky today either, as during his arrest, he suffered a deep cut on his arm as police bundled him to a police vehicle and took him to Nakuru DCI offices for questioning, after which he was released.
Kukusema tu watu za corrupt government, mnatufanyia mambo kama hizi. Mimi mrembavu, mnataka kuniongezea urembavu wingine.
The situation was the same in Mombasa, where traders enjoyed a conducive environment that allowed their businesses to remain open.
People of Mombasa have decided not to go out because they want to give President Ruto time to see, to evaluate if what they demanded the other time will be translated to reality.
At least hata leo kulikuwa na mambo ya nane, lakini hata ukiangalia sasa hivi watu wote wamefungua biashara, hawana hofu kwa sababu sasa hata hii maandamano watu wamechoka.
Leo nimefungua lakini sikuwa naona kama watu wako serious na maandamano.
Elsewhere in Kisumu, Migori and other parts of Nyanza, no demos were witnessed on Thursday, with some of the residents attributing this to inclusion of some of the ODM leaders in government.
MP wetu, Mr. Intellectual, Opia Wandai, kama tumesha pewa hiyo cheo kubwa, sasa tena tufanye mandamano ya nini bwana? Hatuwezi fanya mandamano tena bwana, kwa maana tushaiona Ruto ameenda na sisi sambamba. Na hivyo ndio vile tulikuwa tunaitaka jameni.
Generally the people accepted it consequently. And now they are having a sense of satisfaction in that the narrative of shares government has been partly addressed.
Ken Gashuhi, KTN News.
Meanwhile, relative calm was witnessed in the outskirts of Nairobi during the Thursday.